Here's how you create a diagram. First of all, you should go into your fields here and select the field that you want to have. I'm going to select this one here. And you have a slider up here to make it bigger or smaller. I'll just make it fit the screen like this. Okay. Here on the left side, you have all your paths and accessories that you can add to the diagram. And notice that every time you hover over a sign here, you get a letter, which is the shortcut. So if you press, for example, here B two times, you will get this arrow. And the same for the custom paths. You can directly create your custom paths. If you select this one here, down to settings here, here you can change the setup. So this arrow is always the same, and same with the others. And they all have 1, 2, 3, or 4. So you can easily set them up in here. Adjustment button here, the eraser, text box, and so on. Okay? But here I'm gonna start. I'm gonna start by using some buttons. And I'm gonna use the numbers of the players, of course, 1 to 11. What you can do here, if you select this box here, then you select the first one here, you can automatically change the size here. But what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna place the player here. I have number 1, and because I check this box, I can add the players like this, and it automatically set up the next number. Now I'm ready to think, add it all here in my field. Now I want to add the ball. Here is the ball. And the ball is going to start with the goalkeeper. Just going to zoom in a little bit here so make you see this better. Okay. And now I have the paths. First of all, the ball should have a path and the player should have a path. And you can decide, of course, how you do this, but I always have the straight line for players and a dotted line for balls. Okay. So what I'm going to do here, as before, remember the shortcuts. I'm going to press B 2 times. And then you can see this is selected. Then I left click where the path should begin, release the mouse, and then I drag it over. And once I'm finished, right click to stop. Same thing on the other side. Left click, drag it out, not holding the button, right click to stop. Okay. I want one player here to move in a curve type. So I need to select a curved path. And that's, for example, this B. I press B, left click, and when I want him to turn, I left click again, and then I do the curve, and then right click. Okay. Now pretty much everything is set up in here in my play. I can add some text and just press it in here and write the text. Something like this. Press outside of the box and then I can select the text and move it anywhere around. I can change the font right away here. If I press more options, I can change the thickness and everything like that. And I can move all the arrows, of course. And if I turn, if I grab the endpoints, I can move them like this. Same with the curved ones, I can do them like this, up and down. Now this frame is ready. Then you can just press this button here to add the continuation of this diagram. But you can also just right click and create next frame. If you want an empty frame, you select add frame. So that is different between create next frame and add frame. Now I can see that all my players have moved to the new spot and I can continue drawing on this one. I can also add boxes in circles. Here, if I select, for example, F, I can add a box like this. Now I can go to the, if I press A here, you're going to see this here makes blue. That means if you select something here on the diagram, for example, this circle, this box, you cannot change the box and the size. You can always go here into settings and you can have more options. You can change the color, the size, the border, any way you want. And you can always do this with objects that are already in your diagrams. If you press A and you can select
make something strong, bigger or smaller, for example.
Once I've created this, it's already automatically in my collection, and here you can decide if you have folders or different structure, so you don't have to worry about save button or anything like that.